Hey everybody, it's Liam Sweeney with the Radio Radio X Experience Monthly. We are here for Advertiser's Ambush. We are here with Debbie Lockrow from Artcentric in Driz Store. So we have questions.
Okay.
So you have a lot of really cool stuff. I mean, this stuff's awesome. What would you say is something that you sell a lot of in the category of? Something that you think is pretty popular with people. That doesn't matter.
You can have it.
Yeah, we're pretty good.
So my store is a pretty amazing mix of vintage and furniture, and I concentrate a lot on furniture. So for 30-year-olds, say like mid-century modern, that sells really well. But I love history, and I have furniture from every decade, from Victorian on up.
Oh, well, can we look at like something furniture-wise? Because I've never actually been in here to see furniture. I've only like walked by.
That's shameless. Shameful.
Let's see, something that you can tell us something about a piece that's in here that you find interesting.
So this is a representation of mid-century Haywood Wakefield, very popular, 1950s, 1960s.
I've had that. I've literally had that at my house.
Right? People love it. I also have furniture like this fading couch with custom furniture designed.
Oh wow, that's cool.
Available, so it represents like if your Victorian stuff was very small, this is custom made so that people of all sizes can fit in it. It's an actual couch, but
nice. You know, it's like a lounge where you lay on your side,
exactly.
Kind
of. I also sell a lot of Asian-inspired. There's a beautiful Asian piece right there.
Oh, that's cool.
So
that's
I not only sell furniture that's Asian-inspired. I have lamps. I have decor, dishes. You know, all from like 1920s on up.
So,
I also sell art. I have a mix of local artists, vintage art. Wow. Probably some of the oldest pieces are like 1900s.
Wow.
The same goes with furniture. I have a few pieces every once in a while that are mid-1800s on up. So I mix all the different, you know, time periods.
Okay, so are you like, do people just come in or are you like American Pickers where you go out with the big van?
And American Pickers is an insult to what we do.
Okay.
So I've been doing this for 15 years. People actually call me. I go into their homes. And I buy huge quantities or only a few things. I also go to auctions, but mostly now, I've been doing this long enough, people call me, they trust me, I go to their homes, and I buy a lot.
Wow, that's cool.
And I'm just always looking for these treasures that should never end up in a landfill. It's sad how much time people go, someone passes, and they start throwing it in a dumpster. I like to get to them before, buy as much as I can, you know.
So there's a lot of love that goes into it.
There's a lot of love. I love the history. I love the old furniture. And anyway, it's made from real wood. It's solid. You know, I have IKEA shelves in here, but like, IKEA's not real wood. People, if you buy a piece of furniture from 1920s, it'll be around forever, as long as you're careful with it.
Okay, so let's say you have a wish list, and let's say that there is one thing you would really love to come across. What would that be?
I'm not sure. I have a wish list. I get excited if I go into a house and they have a bunch of like 1960s, 1950s barware, glassware. People love it. It's beautiful colors. I can always sell it. Honestly, I am a curator, not a collector. I love buying this stuff. I love making it look good, but I don't need to own it. So my job is pretty exciting. I get to be around beautiful and unique things. I get to buy beautiful and unique things and curate them for somebody else's home.
Nice. Okay, so what is the address here so that people know?
266 River Street, right near the monument in downtown Troy.
Okay. This has been Advertiser's Ambush from Radio Radio X Experience Monthly.